Evil Genius is a world domination simulation with a sense of humor. Both the supervillains and hero's agents are more like jokes than people. And that's the point. It's a cartoony parody about supervillains with a dark sense of humor. But, especially due to events since it was made, sometimes it's even darker than intended. You have some special henchmen who aid you and who seem to care about each other, which is evil sweet. You can upgrade your worker minions into specialized minions, and you send your people off to go do nefarious deeds. You also build a base and manage it, fitting in what you need and keeping the forces of good out. Except for when you want to torture them because, well, evil. It seems as if the people who made the game cared about adding depth to it. There's an amazing attention to detail. Staying zoomed out is normal because it's easier to control your minions that way. But if you do, you'll miss much of its spirit. If you zoom in, then you can see that little details are all over the place. There are different animations for various NPC actions too, and this level of detail is nice. For example, check out this boat scene. The ocean seems serene, and the song, Tranquil, is so good for the moment. Or should I say, so bad. When your minions run to it, then you can even see a realistic moment as they get onto the boat. They all carefully step down as they board. As if this wasn't enough attention to detail, as the boat takes off, check out the name, Evil One. Moments like this feel like little Easter eggs hidden throughout the game, and there are many of them. So I was disappointed that I disliked the gameplay itself. I disliked it because of two big problems. The first was map-related, causing busy work, which ought to have been unnecessary, and made the game feel horribly tedious. The second problem had to do with the AI. Zmap. A player has to have minions in the field. Stealing on the map is the only way to make money, and building up notoriety by doing missions is how to advance the plot. But the only way to know if these minions are okay or not is to check the map every few seconds. Because minions die to agents if they don't hide whenever one pops up and agents pop up randomly. If these minions die, then you have to retrain new, specialized ones. That takes time. Then you've got to send them out all over again. So it's worth keeping them alive as much as possible. Deaths are setbacks. But being punished for not doing security monitoring is annoying. If you're busy with other tasks, then they'll die. And this also made no sense in-game, because there's no sense getting the boss involved in the security detail. My minions are already analyzing all of this map data. And as the evil genius, I've got no special insight here. You, the evil genius, only get the information by manning these consoles with minions. Plus, I'm supposed to be focusing on world domination? Giving orders? Not this menial surveillance work. The game even notes that this is the sort of work that the minions were hired to do. The boring stuff.
You won't be doing any of the menial work around the base yourself, so your first priority should be to recruit some minions.
As if that's not bad enough, it also shows you that this is something that minions should handle. Because minions can handle security alerts for intruders in the base. And they do this by watching camera monitors. And they can't handle giving the same sort of alerts for the world map monitors. The AI itself wasn't much better than this.
Construction workers must first go to the strongroom to get money to buy the construction materials. They will then go to the depot to buy dynamite.
It was a mess in so many ways. Your unique henchmen die permanently if they lose to super agents 3 times. You're warned to be cautious when engaging them in combat for this reason. However, the henchmen will auto-fight them unless you babysit them and lead them away by the hand. This is bad because if they're out for a smoke break or a walk, then they can lose a life very quickly. You can't control individual minions either. And they often run to their deaths. For instance, if there's a fire, then your weak little social minions, the ones with no combat skills, decide to run toward the fire with fire extinguishers. Even when the minions see that there are hostile enemies in the room, then they still stand in place and get killed as they try to put out the fires. There's no way to stop their reckless bravery unless you manually lock the doors. Also, while objects on fire will explode, there's no threat beyond that. These minions aren't really helping, because the base doesn't get harmed, it's not in jeopardy. It's also not as if he's going to save the object which is currently being shot at. It's on fire because it's being shot at. So this is really, really stupid. Another example happens with traps. Minions should know where the traps are, especially when they have a regular routine of collecting the bodies or confused people from them. They're also seeing the confusing ones on a daily basis. However, if an agent triggers one, then the minions get hit too, because they can neither ignore these surprises nor see the obvious coming and step aside. The best they can manage is not setting off the traps by themselves if they're attentive enough that day. There were other issues too, but they weren't as bad as the AI and map issues. For instance, the base building is restrictive. You can add room space easily, but you can't destroy any existing space unless you destroy the whole room. I would have liked to have been able to destroy individual square tiles in a room, instead of the entire area, to both maximize and minimize my room's areas as needed. You get new items as you research, and what you discover doesn't always have room in the room. I played for about 19 hours on medium difficulty, but then stopped. I knew that I could eventually beat the game, but I hated the feeling of taking one step back and two steps forward over and over again. Minions die, retrain minions, minions die, retrain minions. After 19 hours, this just wasn't any fun anymore. I looked up how long the game takes to beat, and different sites said it took 25 to 30 hours, depending on whether or not someone wants to be a completionist. Playing for another 6 to 11 hours wasn't appealing to me. As for what was going on that disappointed me, I was having special agents attack my base and kill my minions since I couldn't issue orders to either individual minions or minion types. For example, I would have liked to have been able to tell the social group, "Run away." Instead, all I could do was tag an enemy to be handled in a certain way. Kill, capture, confuse, or ignore. But stay away wasn't an option. And as I mentioned, the AI wasn't good. Meanwhile, my minions also died on the world map because I was fending off the special and regular agents and trying to babysit these minions instead of monitoring the monitors and babysitting those minions. As for how the game looks and sounds, as I mentioned earlier, the attention to detail is great. The special henchmen even get catchphrases and individual animations. Some things could be better, sure, but it's good overall, and I liked it. The soundtrack is pleasant. It did more than just blend in when I was playing. There were moments where I noticed it in a good way, because it meshed well, but also sounded cool in the moment. The soundtrack was a free extra with the game. I gave it a listen after playing. It's not something that I like enough to listen to outside of the game, but I tried to because it's great in the context of the game. The game and the music add to each other well. It's worth noting that a sequel is actually coming out this year. This review is being posted in February of 2021, and Evil Genius 2 is set to release in March. I probably will check out the sequel via Let's Plays and see if the flaws in the gameplay have been fixed. After all, if the flaws that I disliked aren't in the next one, then I might like it. It was the flaws that really distracted me because the gameplay didn't match the fun atmosphere that had been generated. I just felt like it was a hassle. Unless a player really loves base management, enough to overlook the game's problems, then I can't strongly recommend this first version of Evil Genius. Despite its good points, I really didn't enjoy Evil Genius due to its gameplay flaws. It looks and sounds nice. Yes, people clearly cared about making a fun game with detail and atmosphere, but I didn't feel like a criminal mastermind issuing orders. Being unable to issue even basic commands like avoid or selecting groups of minions was annoying. Yes. Having to micromanage them like a babysitter wasn't fun. It was as if, instead of Evil Genius, the game should have been titled Minions, because they were running the show, not the player. Their constant deaths and idiocy led to just repetition. I understand the trope that minions are bumbling, but not being able to control them well was a different matter, and really affected my enjoyment of the gameplay. At the very least, the Evil Genius should be able to command them,